Hey guys, my name is Joshua Balata and welcome to my channel. I make educative videos and I thought what better way to introduce my channel than to show you exactly what I do in my channel over here. If you're new to YouTube, then here are 5 tips on how to use YouTube. When you watch a video on YouTube and you want to follow the creator and be notified every time he or she makes new videos, you need to subscribe to their channel and tweak your notification setting. Right below the video, you'll see a subscribe button, clicking which you have subscribed to this creator. Notice there's a bell right next to this. By clicking this button, you're telling YouTube how often you want to be notified by this creator. If it's on, then you will be notified every time he or she makes a video and puts it up. If it's not on, then you will be notified only occasionally. Moving on to number 2. If you listen to music on YouTube, turning it on your computer and then just letting it play, then YouTube has playlists and this works really well. YouTube groups together similar kind of music and you can find playlists to what you want to listen to. Also, some creators create playlists for their viewers like I do. Because they don't want to put all the information in one large video, they break it up into smaller videos and make a playlist. On your Android phone, you can find playlists right next to videos. On your computer or iPad as well, this is the same thing. When you visit the creator's page, first of all, you'll see home, you'll see another tab called videos and another tab called playlists. Number 3. During a video, if a creator wants to reference you to another video or another playlist, he will use YouTube cards. Now, back in the day, they used to have annotations. Those are these little boxes of text that come around the video. YouTube has phased that out right now, although old annotations will still remain, but creators can't make any more annotations. So I won't talk about that. Now YouTube has something called YouTube cards. On your video, you'll see on the right top corner, something pops up and that's the video the creator wants you to watch. Like in this video, for example, I'll reference you to one of my playlists on photos. You will see it popping up right here. Clicking that card, you can see the playlist that I was talking about. If you click the suggestion on a computer, it will open the suggestion in a new tab and this video will be paused so that you can come back to it later. The I, it means information or details. You'll see this in almost all of Google's software. Number 4. If you want to watch this video later, you can create a playlist for yourself and YouTube already has made one for you. It calls it Watch It Later. If you hit the plus logo somewhere up there, it changes depending on your device, but there is a Add to Watch Later playlist somewhere around. On the computer, I remember it's right below the video. What happens here is YouTube has created a playlist for you, called Watch Later, and it adds this video to that playlist. And when you have the time, you can come back and watch from Watch Later. Number 5. To share a video with someone, you just need to hit that arrow key which points to the right. You'll find it again under the video or up there on a phone. Clicking this will open up a new dialog box where you can copy the link and send it via any messaging app. YouTube has released a new feature where they're trying to make themselves a social media platform where you can add friends to your YouTube account and message them. By the way, when someone says I am, that's instant messaging. It means to message someone. Oh yeah, and now YouTube has this new feature where you can double tap on the right to fast forward 10 seconds or double tap to the left to rewind 10 seconds. That's it for this video. I hope that was helpful. YouTube has been a big teacher to me and most of the things that I learned on my computer came from YouTube because there are such awesome creators online who teach you stuff for free. So if you're discovering YouTube and want to catch up with any skill that you've not mastered before, literally anything that I can think of, I can find tutorials on YouTube. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up, and in case you don't like it, give me a thumbs down and tell me why you don't like it so that I can tweak that specific feature for you. Videos on this channel are created for older people who are just getting into using technology and don't have such a nice understanding of their phones, their computers, or their tablets. If the information in these videos are too trivial, please don't get me wrong. I don't think you're cavemen. I just want to make a one-stop shop and teach from the root up all of these technologies. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was not, don't forget to tell me why not and keep learning. I forgot to say this. Depending on which device you're using, all of these features will move around. What I mean is, all these features are still there, but they won't be in the same place, depending on whether you're using a phone, a tablet, or a computer. But if you know what you're looking for, you will find it.